Welcome back. I'm talking with real estate billionaire Sam Zell this weekend. And Sam, a lot of worry signs out there in terms of the world and certainly the president having to deal with issues like North Korea. Your take on these issues that you really can't control. Are you worried about a North Korea threat?
Yes, I'm worried about North Korea, I'm worried about Venezuela, I'm worried about Crimea, I'm worried about a lot of the headwinds around the world because I don't think they're necessarily predictable and they represent risks. In some cases, such in North Korea, you got a situation where the guy is somewhat nuts and he doesn't have, you know, much skin in the game. You know, it's, you know, if you look at the risks he's taking versus the potential power he could get if he succeeded, that's pretty intoxicating.
Yeah, he's got nothing to lose.
That's right.
It doesn't matter what he does. Yeah, it felt like he was backing down, though. The president obviously was very tough, saying if anything happens at all to the United States, North Korea is going to have a major problem. Did he handle that well?
I think he did very well.
Yeah.
And I think he said exactly what he should have said. Probably 2 weeks ago.
Well, one thing that you always have been is a straight talker. And you just wrote a book this summer, Am I Being Too Subtle? Straight Talk from a Business Rebel. Great book, Sam. And I was happy that you finally put these thoughts down on paper. What triggered this? Why did you want to write this book?
Well, people have been encouraging me to write a book forever.
Got great stories.
Yeah, great stories. Really fun. I finally decided that I wanted to share my thoughts and see if I could put something together that would cover my thoughts and yet not turn into a puff piece.
Well, you don't want to be too subtle. You like being a straight talker.
Well, I've taken great pride all my life in the fact that no one has ever left a meeting with me and said, what do you think he meant?
Right. I like that. I saw that in the book.
Well, but that's really what it's all about.
Yeah.
What do they think he meant? At the same time, what I tried to do in the book is take an immigrant's son. You know, I was born 90 days after my parents came to this country.
Wow.
And, you know, and I made a fortune out of my life, both financially and otherwise. All the story of an immigrant. And I wrote the book to all the immigrants in the world to tell them that there's lots of opportunity to do the same thing.
It's just really a wonderful, empowering story because you were able to come from nothing and build great success. So to what do you attribute that? How did you do it, Sam?
I think I started by assuming that conventional wisdom was irrelevant. I just never bought into conventional wisdom, and I never, you know, I look at the Forbes 400, and I see all these guys and take all the people who inherited the money off the list, and everybody else went left when conventional wisdom went right.
Mm.
There's been a lot of times in my life when it's been lonely being, you know, an entrepreneur with a viewpoint that nobody else shared. And there were a lot of times when I looked over my shoulder and said, gee, why aren't there a whole bunch of people waiting in line to do the same thing that I'm doing?
Yeah.
Recognizing the fact that if everybody was doing it, there wouldn't be an opportunity.
Right, but that confidence comes from somewhere. I mean, you had the confidence to make your own way. Were there a couple of breaks along the way that you can remember that really were instrumental in you getting to the next level as you created this empire?
I met a lot of fabulous people, and they set examples for me that I applied going forward. And I think that's where luck enters the picture. And then can you take advantage of the luck when it comes your way?
All right. The best advice from the best in the business. Sam
Thank
Zell,
you.
It's great to see you.
Pleasure, Maria.
Thank you so much. Sam Zell is the chairman of Equity Group Investments and the founder.